Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Go ahead and make the adhan again, inshallah.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمد تعالى ونستعين ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهدي الله فهو مهتد ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن الأصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة وأهلها في النار وعياذ بالله وإياكم من النار أحبتي في الله May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us and bless you forgive us and forgive you and guide us and guide you أحبتي في الله There's no doubt it's a ni'ma min ni'am Allah as the majority of us have become Muslim Alhamdulillah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with hidayah He blessed us with guidance We are following the path, the tariqah to Sahabat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu tal'anhum ajma'in. Because the Sahabat al-Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam radiyallahu tal'anhum ajma'in, they became Muslim. They were not born Muslim. Radiyallahu tal'anhum ajma'in. And we have the fadl of Islam that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided us to Islam. He guided us from darkness to light. Walillahi alhamd. وَهَذَا نِعْمَ مِنْ نِعْمِ اللَّهِ But we have to appreciate that favor from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْمُبِينِ الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيتُ لَكُمْ إِسْلَامَ دِينًا Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْعَزِيزِ Subhanahu wa ta'ala قال, الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ This day I've perfected my religion for you watmamtu alaykum ni'mati and I have completed my favor upon you waradaytu lakum islam deena and I am pleased with islam as your deen so your deen is not the deen of buddhiya being a buddhist and your deen is not the deen of the people of self-help and your deen is not the deen of ahl al-kitab meaning the jews and the christians But rather, we don't celebrate Christmas. Why? Because this involves shirk. Because our deen has two Eidain. It has two Eids. And even Yom al-Jumu'ah is a type of Eid. Or it comes around Isbu'i. It's the Eid Isbu'iyya. It's the Eid of the week. That every week, if you are favored to be in a place where there's a jama'ah, then you have this Eid of Jumu'ah. وَهَذَا نِعْمَ مِنْ نِعَمِ اللَّهِ وَهَذَا مِنْ بَرَكَةِ اللَّهِ عَلَى مُسْلِمِينَ وَنِعْمَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْعَزِيزِ وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِي غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينَ فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْمُبِينِ. And whoever desires other than Islam, a religion. So if they want to be a Buddhist, you want to try some Christianity, you want to try a little self-help, you want to try this or that, all of it is batil, all of it is false. It will only lead you to the hellfire, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and whoever desires other than Islam as a religion, then it will not be accepted from him. And in the hereafter, he'll be of the khasirin. He'll be of the losers. He will lose in the hereafter. And I've known people, they left Islam. They left it. They left this beautiful deen of Islam that brought us together for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him and Him alone. هَذَا نِعْمَ مِنْ نِعَمِ اللَّهِ that we have Islam. But some of the people, they left Islam. So always hold on to your Islam. Always stick with the Islamic Brotherhood to strengthen yourself in Islam. Stick with your brothers. Stick with your family. Stick with Ahlul Sunnah, wherever you find them. Love them, because they are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored with the love of Islam, with tatbiq and the practice of Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْمُبِينِ وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فِي كِتَابِهِ الْكِرِيمِ, He says, and verily this is my straight path, then therefore follow it, and do not follow the subul. Do not follow the other paths. There's so many other paths. Don't follow them. Don't follow and try this and try that. And be careful. A lot of times we don't think that we're trying the other path, but we might be dabbling with other religions and other ideologies. There are how many Muslims, they say, oh, I went to this soothsayer, or I went to this person to find out, to tell me about the future, or I read the Lucky Charm cards, or I did this, or I did that. And they don't even know that they fell into maybe shirk, and some of them fell into kufr. They don't know, because they dabble. Because Islam has already, it's been perfected, as we said in the first ayat. Al-yawm akmaltu lakum dinakum. This day I perfected my religion for you. Allah has perfected Islam. We don't need to search for anything. We don't need self-help. The self-help comes from inside Islam. We don't need the path of those people who go to the graves and call the dead. We don't need that. We don't need to dance around the graves until we're dizzy and slobber comes out of our mouth. That's not going to bring us closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The closeness to Allah comes from following the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sticking to the sunnah of the messenger alayhi salatu wasalam. Wa an Ubay bin Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu anna rasulillahi sallallahu alaihi wasallam qala lahu inna allaha amarani أن أقرأ عليك فقرأ عليه لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب فقرأ فيها إن ذات الدين عند الله الحنيفية المسلمة لا يهودية ولا نصرانية من يعمل خيرا فلن يكفره. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ruwahu tirmidhi wa qala hasan sahih wa sahahahu wal hakim. In this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the hadith of Ubay bin Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read to him, meaning to Ubay bin Ka'b radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inna allaha amarani, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded me, meaning commanded the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and aqra alayk, to read to you, to read this ayat, or these ayat, these verses of the Quran to you. Lam yakun alladhina kafaru min ahli alkitab. Lam yakun alladhina kafaru min ahli alkitab. They didn't disbelieve the people of the book, meaning the people of the book didn't disbelieve until the clear message came to them, when the sunnah was clear to them, or the way of the people even before, when the messengers came with the truth, that's when the people divided. Subhanallah, you'll find the people divide when the truth becomes clear to them. It becomes clear. How can we have so many groups and sects in Islam? The truth is there. The book of Allah is there. The sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is there. The way of the first three generations, the Salaf as-Salih, it's there. That straight path is there. But the people still pick and choose. They say, it's not enough. We need to have some tasawwuf. We need to look for our inner spirituality. Where's the inner spirituality? It's in the book of Allah. And it's in the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it's ala madhhab as-Salaf as-Salih. It's in the way of the Salaf. We don't have to look inner to anything that's not already there in Islam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he read this to him. And then he read another verse. And he said, and verily this is the religion which is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hanifiyatu Muslima. The religion of pure monotheism, that's a Muslim, Islamic religion, not the way of Judaism or Christianity. And whoever does good, they will not go astray. And this is from a hadith, Ruahu Tirmidhi. أَقُولُ قُولِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلُ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. أما بعد هبت في الله. It's so important to hold on to your Islam and be brothers for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says في كتابه المبين وتعاون على بر وتقوى ولا تعاون على إثم وعدوان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and cooperate all of you together in righteousness and piety, and do not cooperate in hatred, enmity, wudwan, in jealousy and hatred. You know, all of those wicked traits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dislikes. Do not cooperate in that. Don't cooperate in deviancy in the religion. If you know people are practicing a certain practice, there are so many groups and sects that are out there calling you away from what Allah has revealed, and they say that this is good. Come with us. We're Muslim. Let's go protest. We're Muslims. Let's go do this. We're Muslims. Let's go to an Islamic nightclub. We're Muslim. Let's go to this. Let's go to that. No. Keep it on the book of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, and keep safety and away from those various paths and various ways of the people of desires. وعن أبي هريرة الدوسي رضي الله تعالى عنه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال والذي نفس محمد بيده لا يسمع به أحد من هذه الأمة يهودي ولا نصراني ثم يموت ولم يؤمن بالذي أرسلت به إلا كان من أصحاب النار. Ruahu Muslim. This is a hadith in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu qal, that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, by the one whose hand Muhammad's soul is in, meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is not anyone from this nation, not from the Jews nor the Christian, that hears of me and dies and doesn't believe in what I have been sent with, except they will be in the hellfire. Meaning that anyone who hears and understands anything about Islam, they need to accept it. They need to practice Islam. You need to practice your Islam. So learn more, because Islam is going to give you everything good. And this is a hadith in Muslim. When Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu qal, خط رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خطا بيده ثم قال هذا سبيل الله مستقيمة ثم خط على يمينه وعلى شماله ثم قال هذه سبل ليس منها سبيل إلا عليك إلا عليه شيطان يدعو إليه. This is the hadith of Abdullah bin Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And he said that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he drew a line in the sand. خَطَّ لَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. He drew a line. And he said, "Hadha sabil Allah." So he drew a straight line like in the sand. And he said, "This is the straight path. It's the sabil Allah. It's the path of Allah, like the Sirat al-Mustaqim." So he said, "This is the sabil Allah al-Mustaqim, the straight path of Allah." Then he drew one on the right and he drew one on the left. And he said, "These are the paths of the shaitan." And that they're at the head of each one of those paths, there's a shaitan that calls to it. That shows us that there's only one path to Jannah. We can't say, you know, I'm a Buddhist Muslim. I'm a Catholic Muslim. There are people who say this. You know, I'm a self-help Muslim. I'm a this Muslim. I'm a that Muslim. Or they are Muslim, but they take other paths than the Sunnah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thumma qara. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he read the ayat, which we read before, وَأَنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِي مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ. Then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he read the ayat where Allah says, and verily this is my straight path. Because when we talk about the straight path, that means it's Allah's path. It's not anything we made up of, or our friends made up, or our group made up. It's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's His subhanahu wa ta'ala straight path. Because Allah says, verily this is my straight path, therefore follow it. And do not follow any of the other ways. Don't follow the other paths. And then the Prophet, Ruahu Nisa'i fi Sunan al-Kubra. And in another hadith, وَقَالَ أَبُو بَرْزَةَ الْأَسْلَمِ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ أَنْقَذَكُمْ بِالْإِسْلَامِ وَبِمُحَمَّدٍ رُوَاهُ بُخَارِي. So this is a hadith or a narration of one of the Sahaba radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And he said, verily Allah has saved you with Islam. He saved you with Islam and with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he saved you with Islam and Muhammad. That's why following the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is an obligation upon us. And in the last narration of our Salaf as-Salih, waqala Mujahid al-Makki rahimahullah ta'ala, ما أدري أي نعمتين علي أعظم أن هداني للإسلام أو أعفاني من هذه الأهواء رواه الدارمي. This is a narration of one of the classical scholars, maybe one of the tabi'een, meaning he was a follower of the Sahaba رضي الله تعالى عنهم أجمعين. And he said, I don't know which favor, which blessing is better, which is the best, better blessing for me? Which is greater? I don't know which one. He said that Allah guided me to Islam or that He protected me from desires, meaning from bid'ah. So even the Salaf, the classical scholars, the Sahaba, the Tabi'een, they were concerned about people changing the religion and having new ways of practicing, new understandings, new aqidah, new ideologies. They were concerned about that. They were the mutamassikina, they held on to the sunnah like this. And in fact, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, alaykum bi sunnati wa sunnatu khulafa rashidin al-mahdiin adhu alayha bin nawajid. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it's upon you my sunnah and the sunnah of the rightly guided khulafa rashidin al-mahdiin, meaning the sahaba, tabi'een, wa tabi'een. And he said, adhu alayha bin nawajid. He said, cling to it with your molar teeth. Your molar teeth are here in the back of your mouth. So if you cling to something with your molar teeth, that means you're really biting it. It's not here, it's here. That means you're biting it. And that's what the Prophet ﷺ made as an example, that the importance of clinging to the sunnah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Almighty, to accept our good and forgive our evil. Bless us with ikhlas, with the bad of the sunnah of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam everywhere and guide us and feed us and clothe us and shelter us and bless us with rizq and bless us with provisions. And may Allah tabarak wa ta'ala protect us from our enemies and bless us to be those who represent Islam and practice Islam and understand Islam and learn Islam and share Islam. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam wa iqam as-salah. Allahu Akbar.